Hello and welcome to Let's Play Civilization 6, Episode 17. In the inter-turn, my Wonder completed building. Let's see if it gave me. Yeah, it gave me a lot of amenities because of this thing. But I'm losing food, so let me figure out something here. Let's build a... mobile Sam, but while I'm doing that, I want to build a worker as well. Or builder, I keep saying worker, but I meant builder. Okay, we finished that. Gonna do Preslov, Nanmadal, and Valletta again. And got the modern armor here. That is really cool. Just looking at the animation of the tank as it rolls through. So, up that. Building another balloon. Am I building? Where's. Okay. And if I look at the overall score. I'm not in a joint war with them anymore. That's really weird. It seems to have bugged out because the joint war I did with them was against Brazil, but we're at peace now. So, but somehow the reason the tooltip is still there. Here. But we're not in a joint war anymore. We're at peace. Someone stole our gold. Chinese again. I don't like this. And I'm getting trigger happy. Yeah, let's send that to Congo. No, actually no, let's not do that. Let's send that to Africa. Let's do an archaeological museum. Washington. Penelope, okay. Confirm placement. Good counter spy again. Right. Okay, they broke a promise. Is that a casus belli? No. I would think that would be one. Okay, I did finish my spaceport. I need to figure out what I need to do next. What I do like about this is...
There is nothing like a dream to create the future.
When I go to the victory screens, the science victory is like a bunch of switches. You can see here, it tells you exactly what I need. So I need to launch an Earth satellite. And I have different steps. I have to build a spaceport, research rocketry, I've done that. And then I'm ahead of the Greeks because I have all these other prerequisites I've done already. I just haven't done the heavy lifting of, you know, launching stuff. So let's see what I can do here. Launch a satellite. So I do have Carl Sagan and this scientist here that will, if I wake her. Okay. If I wake him, 3,000 production points towards space race contraction, which is what I'm doing here, so let's do that. Whoa. That is awesome. Well, so I've done that. That was a quick completion. What's my next step here? Launch moon landing. So I'm just going through the steps now. Only 6 turns. I'm going to save her for the Mars mission. And yeah, that's the other thing here is in previous Civ games, you always go to Alpha Centauri. And this is the very first Civ game where the space race victory is to land on Mars, which is more realistic, and I think it's a lot more current as well, and I like that. Oh yeah, and I just did that.
战则战矣, 寡人其将铸成尔等.
Goodbye.
यदि आप खून के इतने प्यासे हैं,
sorry Gandhi,
तो आपके नेतृत्व को समाप्त करना ही बेहतर होगा.
My words will be back with Nyx very soon, so I don't really care. It's nice to be able to play with my new toys. I don't want to attack their districts because I want to keep them once I take over the cities. Yeah, they definitely nerfed the bombard strength of air units, like especially against land units. I'm not doing all that much damage. I actually need troops to move troops in to take cities. Future tech here. Let's try bombing that city. An interesting strategy you can do if you're doing a war of attrition is to actually, instead of attacking the cities and attacking the units, is to take out all their infrastructure. So the their research center here, I think that's their faith center, and just take them all out. That's actually a valid strategy in this game that's not present in previous versions. I think you could pillage in the previous versions, but it's different from what actually you could do in this game. In Civ 3 you could bombard improvements. Civ 4 they took that out, and Civ 5 they kind of didn't really put that back in. I think it was I'm claiming a great person here. Sure. So yeah, in Civ 5 you could can't bombard. Yeah, I think Civ 5 you could pillage, but not bombard and do damage to the city. Some of these generals I could retire probably and get something out of them. Yeah, let me turn this into a unit. I'm gonna try working on the battleship. fighter didn't get much use, so I'm just gonna use it to bombard, get some extra bombard points in. Oh, I'm gonna actually sink it. But it actually took 4 attacks. That's a fairly high amount of attacks. And I think what they did in this game was they reduced the range of the artillery and increase or kept the same the range of air forces. So there's that balance there. If you want safe risk-reward trade-off, if you want safe bombardment, relatively speaking, then you want to go with your air force. But if you want more damage, you want to go with your artillery and range units. But that would mean actually sending those units in harm's way. Why is my moon mission almost finished? 5 turns. Actually surprised it didn't take a lot of damage. I wonder what I'm missing here. I have a great general, right? Yeah. Oh, the artillery is in full power, so that's one reason. And I have an artillery here that's 6 turns away. That is one huge army. Where are they going? Who's Congo at war with? No one yet. Sorry, Gandhi. Oh, there's a Chinese cannon. I can also tell they reduced the firepower of artillery quite a bit. Although this one's quite effective compared to what I have been doing here. Let me rest them up. Returns. I'm gonna buy a rocket artillery. I do have range because I can actually send the Air Force down to support this city because this one is coming down quite well. Two turns to my nuke, my first at least. Three turns to moon landing. Okay. Send that to Argos. Did they pillage here? Oh. How close are we to culture? We're almost there to culture too. We might win culture before we actually win space. But this game, as my first real game, is mostly experimental anyways, just figuring out how the battle system works, the victory system works, little quirks. And I'm sure the game's gonna get patched pretty soon too, to fix some of the more glaring AI shortcomings. So things are gonna change. Okay, let's use our bombers to attack this city here. It's a bit of a tough nut to crack, actually. Weaker than, a lot stronger than I thought it would be. Compared to the capital city, which was much less well defended. I do like this little detail of having the air bases actually on the map and not like hidden in the city. In Civ 3 there were airstrips that your workers could build, but that was kind of a one-time deal, and it just helped you extend the range of your airplanes, but it's not really a district. This actually is its own thing. You can build airports, build a hangar, and that will increase the carrying capacity of your Air Force, because it looks like each city can only carry one plane, so to be able to concentrate a lot of planes you need to build an airstrip, which is kind of neat. Let's try that. Jet fighters versus spearmen, go! Okay, he wiped it out. I would be disappointed otherwise. Isaiah. I'm gonna keep you in the city for now. Oh, I have an upgrade here. Let's do that. Gandhi has 3,000 gold. I wonder where he got some of that from.
Distracted from distraction by distraction.
I'll keep it. Oh, it just increases my point towards score victory each time I do it. but I get the same civics, I think. Okay, one turn to moon landing, so I want to probably end with that. Let's build another rocket artillery. And here, let's build a bomber. City is about to fall. We'll stay in Washington. Can I build a, or buy an archaeologist now? Too many, oh, I gotta move this naturalist out. There we go, we build it a museum so we can build an archaeologist. And he's, okay. Let's also buy a builder. Some of the buildings here. Where did they move their capital to? Oh, okay. That's one massive city. Dorothy to oh, she's already in a mission, okay. Isaiah is not in a mission. No, actually I'm gonna move him to Delhi. I guess I could help him out, Preslav, getting rid of all these barbarians. Use my air force to kill them. Shall we? Let me send in the troops. Good, we can build two more trade routes, so let me do that too. Oh, I now have a nuclear device. Do I want to use it? Probably not. Okay, we should get our moon launch. There's a rocket there.
The worth of a culture is not measured by its accomplishments, but in how those accomplishments last and how they are remembered. The beauty that you have inspired our people to create will ensure that our culture stands for all time.
Too bad I didn't get to see the moon landing. That'll be maybe for next time. Dan Quayle, they still have Dan Quayle in there. That's such a funny thing. It's been there since at least Civ 2. It's a kind of a joke if you don't do very well. Okay, I think I'm done here. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you next time. Okay, I hit just one more turn, so we'll see our moon launch before we end this episode. Hopefully, we'll see the moon launch. Just waiting for the... just waiting for... There we go.
Even though the future seems far away, it is actually beginning right now. It has been said that arguing against globalization...
All right, I think that was it for the moon launch. I was hoping there was a moon landing as well, but I guess not. But I think that's a fairly good way to end the episode. Thank you very much again for watching. I will see you in the next series. Goodbye.